Hey, this is the game, Triple H from the WWE. You're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching.
You're watching. You're watching.
Warrior.
The Warrior.
Warrior.
Warrior. Warrior Report.
Aircam.
Urs.
Welcome to another edition of the Warrior Report, the show for soldiers and their families of the 1st Brigade Combat Team, 10th Mountain Division. I'm Specialist Luke Allen.
And I'm Specialist Jason Jordan. Iraqi security forces recently discovered the largest cache ever found in the Kirkuk province.
I'm Senior Michelle Emery with Combat Camera. I had the chance to go behind the scenes at the Fob McHenry dining facility to see what really goes on.
Not everyone sees what goes on behind the scenes at Fob McHenry's dining facility to make hot meals possible for deployed troops.
We have three hit times, of course. We have breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Everyone sees all the finished product. That's what they see. The prep starts at 03:45 in the morning, and we go from there.
We feed about 200 soldiers. I think that'd be probably a minimum. Morale, it's mostly a morale booster. It's actually just to come together and fix even just anything, something simple.
We're able to give them a hot meal, stuff that's not just MREs, something that they look forward to, like the Italian meal. Or, I don't know. It's nice when people like what we're doing.
It's a morale booster for each other, and to see everybody coming here smiling and be able to sit down and eat together, knowing they're away from their families.
The only ones that actually get to see our work is our cooks, of course, and when we have KPs with us, sometimes they like to join in on the fun, because it's actually fun cooking. A lot of people don't see that. It's hard work, for sure, but it's very enjoyable. We love what we do, most of us. We complain, but we love what we do.
Although they work long hours, these soldiers always find a way to enjoy themselves while cooking in a war zone. Reporting for the 1st Brigade 10th Mountain Division at Fob McHenry, Iraq, I'm Combat Camera Photographer, Senior Airman Michelle Emery.
Iraqis just graduating from Kirkuk's Police Academy. Specialist Luke Allen has more.
1,325 Iraqi police recruits graduated during a ceremony held at the Kirkuk Police Academy recently in northeastern Iraq. Coinciding with Iraq's Emergency Services Recognition Day, the Iraqi police conducted a pass and review in front of their senior leadership, representing Iraq's police force, army, emergency services, and other departments within the Ministry of Interior and the Ministry of Defense. Kirkuk city and provincial government officials were also in attendance.
At this time also we need to thank the
honorable people from the awakening that are also joining our efforts in trying to fight terrorism. And we need to thank the Iraqi army that also supported us and the different political parties and security forces that have supported us, as well as coalition forces that gave and provided support, logistical, financial, and even moral.
Senior military leadership from the 1st Brigade 10th Mountain Division were also on hand to show their support.
I want to turn my attention now and my comments to those young men who graduate from the police academy today. I want to thank them for successfully completing their training, but having the courage to join the ranks of the police force. These young men, your country and your province needed you, and you have the bravery to step forward and be counted.
The course can run between 9 to 15 weeks to meet the 400 hours of training required by the Ministry of Interior. A ceremonial band played throughout the procession to help keep the rhythm of the mass movement. IPs in ninja attire followed the procession, entertaining the hundreds in attendance with a martial arts demonstration. The demonstration concluded with the release of confetti, pigeons, and the unfurling of the Iraqi flag, symbolizing hope and security and the rebuilding of a new and more secure Iraq. Reporting for the 1st Brigade 10th Mountain Division, I'm Specialist Luke Allen.
Let's take a break from our story to show you photos from around the Warriors AO.
Just a chance that maybe we'll find better days. 'Cause I don't need boxes wrapped in strings and designer love and empty things. Just a chance that maybe we'll find better days. So take these. Faith and trust and peace while we're alive. And the one poor child who saved this world, and there's 10 million more who probably could if we all just stopped and said a prayer for them. So take these words. Yeah.
You're watching the Warrior Report.
And I'm trying to call Warrior.
General Mike Ghost just recently visited the soldiers from the 1st Brigade Combat Team. Specialist Luke Allen has more.
Major General Mike Oates, 10th Mountain Division and Fort Drum Commander, along with 10th Mountain Division Command Sergeant Major James Redmore, thanks soldiers of the 1st Brigade Combat Team for their hard work and dedication. Oates and Redmore visited with soldiers throughout the 1st BCT January 24th and 25th, recognizing their efforts and informing them on the state of the division. Major General Oates also stated that despite rumors, 1st Brigade is still slated for a 15-month tour, and encouraged soldiers that what they are doing here in Iraq is appreciated in the States. He also informed soldiers that new barracks were being completed on post and that single 1st Brigade soldiers would be some of the first to move in. Drum TV producer Kay Young was also visiting from Fort Drum, as she is producing a video special entitled The Heart of the 10th Mountain Division in Iraq. You can view the show on the Drum TV website, www.drum.army.mil/drumtv. Reporting for the 1st Brigade 10th Mountain Division, I'm Specialist Luke Allen. Specialist Kerry Reeves with the 10th Brigade Support Battalion recently teamed up with 187 Infantry Scout Team. Specialist Jason Jordan has more.
Although scouts are trained in the Army's latest infantry tactics, and many of them graduates of the U.S. Army Ranger School, the soldiers that conduct combat operations with them are not always scouts and not always men. Specialist Kerry Reeves of the 10th Brigade Support Battalion, which is assigned to the Forward Support Company for 187 Infantry, has been aiding the scouts on many of their missions. The scout soldiers often have to search personnel for weapons or evidence of terrorist activity as they conduct combat operations, but male soldiers are not allowed to search females. Therefore, female soldiers must accompany the scouts on their missions. Reeves recently searched more than 50 Iraqi females during a mission that would eventually lead to the capture of two high-value targets who had attacked soldiers on Forward Operating Base McHenry. Reeves says that it was great to be a part of the mission that caught the people responsible for hurting her friends. Reporting for the 1st Brigade 10th Mountain Division in Kirkuk, Iraq, I'm Specialist Jason Jordan.
It's a Triple Deuce Medical Platoon Painkillers!
And you're watching the Warrior Report!
An urban legend says that the 10th Mountain Division brings snow with them wherever they go. Specialist Luke Allen has more.
Snow. It's something you might find at Fort Drum, but you wouldn't expect it in Iraq.
Most people wouldn't believe that it could snow in a mostly dry desert climate. But this is war, and stranger things have happened.
The locals here in Kirkuk, Iraq say that snow is not normal. They say we brought it from Fort Drum.
It is said that the 10th has a legacy. Wherever mountain soldiers go, so does the snow.
We bring it with us wherever we go.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, in the heat or cold of snow, right?
This is Louisiana in early spring of 2007. You guessed it, the 1st Brigade of the 10th Mountain Division was in town for training. Some say it's a blessing, some say it's a curse, but for some, it's just something that comes with being a mountain soldier.
Is there a legend behind it?
Yeah.
Now, I'm not sure of it, but I'm sure there is. There's, you know, a method to the madness. We bring it with us.
Reporting for the 1st Brigade 10th Mountain Division, I'm Specialist Luke Allen.
Well, that's all the time we have for this edition.
Stay tuned for more stories from the front lines.
And remember,
when news breaks,
We fix it.
Ready? General Mike Coates just recently visited the soldiers for the 1st Brigade Combat Team. Specialist Luke Allen, take over.
I've got another story for you.
When news breaks, we fix it.
It's a montage.
Yes, Samuel, you're probably right. It's probably not possible to lift off the ground without the propellers.
It's science!
It's a strange shot.
Kiowas without propellers. Propellerless Kiowas.
Oh. In Kirkuk.
You guys can't watch it. Can't watch it! Alright, here we go.
A new government experiment! Kiowas without propellers!
Kid sister. Kid sister.
That's good. Yeah.
We're watching the Warrior Report.
One, two, one, two, one, two. Work it. Yeah, yeah, yeah.